today we are going to talk about another line, important line segment in a triangle, the angle bisector of a triangle. Last time we talked about the property of an altitude in a right triangle, the altitude and the hypotenuse. It was special in the sense that it was for only for right angle triangle and not any altitude but only the one on the hypotenuse. This is a result for any angle bisector, any of the three, in any kind of triangle at all. Let's see what the result is. The result is something like this, that if you have a triangle and if you take the angle bisector named the triangle ABC and the angle bisector is AB. Then the result is that in any triangle, if you take an angle bisector as here, then AB upon AC, the two sides which form the angle that you have taken, you take its ratio and you take the ratio of the two parts of the third side. And if you have taken AB first, you take BD first. So it is BD upon DC. Or in other words, AB upon AC is BD upon BC. Now, it's easier for us in the models if we have products instead of the ratio. So what we do is we take, this is what we want to prove, then that AB into DC is equal to AC into BD. And this is what we shall try to do with the help of a model. We start. Here is a triangle, any triangle that you like, and we call it ABC, referring to it there. Take the angle bisector of angle A and it meets here in D, so this is our D. And we want to prove that AB upon AC is BD upon BC. Or before I look at this in the model, I'll show you what we have done in the model. The two sides AB and AC of the triangle we have taken in red. One is single, the other is double line. The two parts of the third side BC we have taken in green. One single, the other double. Single on one side, double on the other side. Now, what we want to do is AB into DC. This is AB into DC. That means we want to prove that these two, if you take the product AB into DC, must be equal to AC into BD. AC into BD is this, what I have held. Now you can see this is two red and one single green. This is single green and single red and double green. So when you take your product, you must have one of red and green. One of red and green and one of single line or double line. So it is single red and double green or single green and double red. That is what we want here in our model. Okay, what we do is, we are going to use the same thing that we did last time. Take a big triangle and take two small triangles, move them and so on. But here, if you cut along this as we did last time, we will not get dry triangles. We need dry triangles for this. Not only that, you will see that they will also turn out to be similar. What we do is, we form two small right triangles. One whose sides are equal to the red ones. As you can see, the red double line and red double line, and here red single line and red single line. So this is a right triangle whose two sides are the two red sides AB and AC. And naturally the other one is with the two green sides, green and red. And these are the sides which form the right triangle, not the hypotenuse. Now, do exactly what we did last time. Now that we have our two triangles, place one here and the other there. From the big triangle, take away the two small triangles. What shall we be left with? The rectangle in between. And what is its area? Its area is one green, single green and double red. Single green and double red, as you can see here. Single green and double red is this and this. Single green and double red. So it is BD into AC. We have got this already. Now, just move. And change the places. Same thing again. From the big triangle, take away the two small triangles. Same big triangle, same two triangles, small triangles. What we are left with is this rectangle. It is single red and double green. Single red and double green is AB into CD. It is this. Now what? So we got the two sides by taking the triangles in two different ways. Have we got them equal? Not yet. Let us see if they are equal. What we did was, from the same big triangle, in both the cases we removed the same two small triangles. So what remains has to be the same every time. And so what remained was, once it was this, the other time it was this, and therefore the two are equal. So that finishes with the demonstration of the model, which convinces us that yes, AB into BC is equal to AC into BD. The next question is to make this model. And how do we make this model? We have understood the model, so it's not going to be difficult. First of all, we make this triangle. Take any triangle at all. I'm not showing now on a paper or cutting it and so on. Take any triangle on a paper like this. Draw it. Draw its angle bisector and mark the two sides, single red and double red, single green and double green. That helps us in seeing the whole thing very easily. Then prepare these two triangles, two right triangles. So we have to prepare now two right triangles. Two right triangles whose sides are equal to the two red ones, or AB and AC. So the lengths of these sides are AB and AC, and it is a right triangle. Now remember, we have marked this as red and the other one. Now here in the figure I have put single line and double line to show that we have double line in the figure. Now the other triangle with one side single a green and the other side equal to the double green. So now we take the other triangle whose lengths are single green and double red. So BD and AC. We have taken like this. It is CD. I put the same one there. This is double green, so CD. And this one is single green, so this is BD. These are the two segments of BC. These are the two sides of the angle that we have taken. Now what we have to do is make the big triangle for the tray. This one. And how do we take it? Now we know that it has to fit in like this. It has to be a right triangle, of course. So we take a right triangle. But we do not know the length of the two sides. Now let us see the length of the two sides here. The length along this is double green and double red. If you see it closely, you will note, and if you make your model also, you will be able to see that double green and double red. Double green and double red is AC plus CD. So this side is AC plus CD. And now what about this side? This is single green and single red. That is AB and BD. So this is AB and BD. And that makes up our frame or tray for the two triangles. And then these two triangles have got to fit in there, once here and once then next time there, and ultimately give us this result. I'm sure you'll be able to make this yourself. We have not taken any paper and cut this time, but we can see it. Once we have the drawing, you can put it on the paper and cut it. Or you can draw it on the paper and cut it. Well, okay. Once again, I would like to remind you that this result is for any triangle and is true for any of its angle bisector. So instead of this angle bisector, suppose we have taken this angle bisector, then we would say that AC upon BC is equal to AP upon PB. So it is true for each of the three. Well, okay. Thank you.